Antonio Brown has already gotten his first workout as a Buccaneer under his belt, and it went well. Bruce Arians said the veteran receiver looked, quote, fantastic, and that the two had a really good conversation. Former NFL defensive back Orlando Scandrick joining Undisputed. Orlando, great to have you. I'm going to start with you. Will AB work out in Tampa?
I think it does. The situation is a great situation for him. He doesn't have to be like the guy right away, but he's going to be a serious, serious weapon. I compliment Tom Brady, Bruce Arians, Jason Light for that signing, and it just keeps getting better. The rich keep getting richer.
Mm-hmm. I agree with you. I think it'll work for the simple fact it's only going to be half a season. So, and plus, if we're to believe what BA said, is that I sat down and I had a great conversation with him. I think that's the thing that you have to do. When you bring these guys in, no matter, you know, what the situation is, let's talk about what our expectations are from you. And it's a very short line here. There's only one way to do things. It's my way or you're on trail way. There is no late for meetings, not even one. There is no missed practice or late for practice, not even one. So,
but
go ahead.
But as a player, and I think you can relate to this as a player, you respect honesty. So if that's
yes.
a true conversation that him and BA had, and it was an honest conversation, and he told him what he wanted, and he laid it out, and Antonio laid out what he was going to be. But BA's got to stick to that. If Antonio's late one time, if he results back to that behavior because he's not getting the ball, he's got to stick to his word, because Antonio is a hell of a player, but he's one of those people you got to kind of keep your thumb on. You got to kind of keep, if you go back and you look what happened with the Steelers, early on, he was great. He was fantastic. Even Ryan Clark said it. But once he got better and once the success started to creep in, it was one of those guys that they seen. Once you paid him, you weren't going to be able to control him.
Right. And you allowed him to be late. So 5 minutes turned into 10 minutes, turned into, like, later for this, Gil. Oh, practice, what we need that for? Because, like, but here's the thing. And then it got to the point where he became, like you said, he became uncontrollable. And then he started bucking on anybody that would challenge him. Like, AB, don't do that. What you mean? I'm a Pro Bowl. I'm all this, all that. But now he understands. After being away from the league is going to survive. Remember, he went on IGRO and says, I'm going to do things my way. If they don't want to play by my rules, they're not going to play. I'm not going to play. He found out the NFL has been in business for now 101 years. They're going to be in a business for another 101, and they'll be in there without Antonio Brown. He understands that now. So hopefully I hope it works out, because I believe that he's paid his debt to the NFL. Now, they got some other things going on. He's going to have to pay his debt to society, whatever that case may be. But the NFL says he's free and clear with us. So I hope it works out. But like you said, he's a guy you got to keep your hand on, because at least when you least expect it, he going to be AB. AB going to be AB. So BA needs to be BA.
I'm sorry. I'm calling baloney on your last statement. You do not hope it works out. You hate Tom Brady.
No,
Skip. You don't want to see Tom Brady win another Super Bowl.
Skip, it doesn't change my life. It doesn't.
It changes your life in that seat every day.
Why?
Because it's hotter and hotter. Wronger and wronger.
He wins another Super Bowl because he linked up with great talent, because that's what you said about LeBron. LeBron won all the talent. So now, what you criticize LeBron for, you praise Tom Brady for getting all the talent, right?
But time out.
Yeah.
You were the one who went on the record about Antonio Brown and said there's no way you'd have him on your team.
No, that's not my team.
Okay.
I'm talking about me.
If Tom Brady makes it work with AB, goes and wins a Super Bowl with Antonio Brown,
yes.
who the Steelers couldn't control and the Raiders just blew apart
with. One second, Skip. But AB is a guy that when he respects you, he stays in line. He lost all respect for Ben Roethlisberger. That's why he started to buck him. He lost all respect for Mike Tomlin. He started to buck him. I don't think he ever had respect for Mike Mayock or whatever. What's the guy that's the
GM Mayock.
Down there? Mayock. So you see that blew up. I don't think he ever respected Gruden. That blew up. You know, the guy ain't going to practice, complaining about a helmet. But then he gets down there to New England and everybody say, it's not going to work. It's not going to work. And look what happened in the first game. You know, that was cut short by some other issues that AB has going on that he has to handle. But you, as a Tampa Bay Bucs, you can never have too much talent. And at the end of the day, if the talent fits with the culture, then, you know, sky's the limit.
Okay. I went on record the first day and said this isn't a good move. It's a great move because it involves the GOAT at quarterback, who does have a rapport and a respect with AB, and I think it's mutual. I think Tom Brady just is in awe of AB's ability to run routes and how hard he works in practice. Right. Remember John Gruden and Hard Knocks were screaming, 84! You're going to lead this league in energy, mm-hmm. right? Well, he does.
Right.
And he electrifies your whole practice because he loves to practice. So does Brady.
Right.
Okay? But the head coach of the Buccaneers wrote him off, wrote off AB as a, called him a diva and yeah. said he'd be a bad fit here. He wants no part of him. And he did coach him for a little while right. in Pittsburgh when AB was a young player.
Right.
And then AB said, oh, we sat down and had a really good conversation today because now he wants credit for having brought him in.
Well, Tom,
you deserve none,
AB. Tom talked him into it, Skip.
I guess so. Well, that's what happened to me. So, look, do I think there will be some internal conflict with AB and somebody? He's who he is. I don't think he's a nice guy. I don't think he's a good guy. He's had issues wherever he's been. Will he rub somebody raw in the locker room? Will he get on under somebody's skin? Will he maybe be 4 minutes late to a walkthrough? Mm-mm. Just watch. Just watch. He will, and they'll just have to look the other way, and Tom will have to handle it.
Well, see, you're starting a bad precedent looking the other way, because that's what the Steelers did. They looked the other way, and then all of a sudden, they didn't have to look because he wasn't showing up.
But last point, though, you know what this league is about. We're going to tolerate you until you can't do nothing for us.
Tolerate you until you replace you.
Yeah, they'll tolerate 10 weeks, which is 2.5 months, as long as it's doing something for them. You'll tolerate a lot for a Super Bowl. Mm-hmm. Now, when you start struggling a little bit and you got to ask yourself what's going to happen down the road when you get into one of these 20, 23 games and it's the last drive and AB might have thought he was open and the things didn't go his way, you would just like to think, I would like to think as a man and as a player that Antonio has learned his lesson and knows this is his last chance.
And what about the two Pro Bowl receivers, Mike Evans, Chris Godwin? Are they going to be real happy about this?
No.
When they get three catches instead of eight?
Mike Evans is fine. I think Godwin shows you when Tom comes and he hands over his jersey number for nothing, he shows you what kind of guy he is. I think those guys want to win. I think Mike's been there so long and the culture's been so bad and the losing's been sunk in. I think now he's got a chance to win. He's got all the money. You know, and now with the chance to win, you know, and the chance to be cemented in Tampa Bay history, I think they'll be fine.
It's going to be very interesting because it's hard, when you go from being a Pro Bowl thought of as a top 2, 3, 4, 5 receiver, and all of a sudden you catch him because he's getting half the numbers that he normally gets. And the question is, how do we keep everybody happy? Because that's what happened last year in Cleveland. You remember Freddie came, we got enough ball. We're going to keep everybody happy. And he kept no one happy.
No one.
And then it ended up falling apart. But I believe Tom Brady because of Brady. Because at the end of the day, the quarterback must have the ultimate respect. And the thing that I like about Tom, and Tom reminds me a lot of John, even though a lot of my success came through his hands, he never said, well, you're successful because of me.
You're talking about
John Elway. Yeah. And see, I think Ben might have said some things that rubbed AB the wrong way, where you do realize that your success is really tied to me. And because that's Absolutely. Why AB, and that's why AB tweeted what he tweeted. Oh, you think it's because of you? Let me go somewhere else and I'll show you. Yeah. So hopefully, I hope it works out because I don't know, this is last chance you for AB. Because if it doesn't work with Tom Brady and it doesn't work with BA,
True.
Where is he going to go? Where is he going on now?
Mm. Home. Okay. Back down that lonely road. But what we can all say, Skip, you included, because you played sports at some point in your life, sharp, multi, Super Bowls, winning cures all.
It does.
Winning to make things go away. You look down there in Kansas City, they got all those weapons. You know, 1 week, Tyreek might have 180. 1 week, they might rush for 150, 200. 1 week, Sammy Watkins may be the guy. But, you know, those guys never complain. And when you winning and being down there with those guys, just they love football. And when you winning, winning cures all.
And by the way, Shannon did not complain when he went to Baltimore and was catching like one ball a game, except you're only throwing 3 balls a game, right?
That's it. That's it. But you know that 1-0? I would take that thing to the house. I'll pick it up. Go. Mm. I don't need but one. All the ball. Oh, they need 10. Throw me 10 balls. Give me one in the right situation.
Ray Lewis and
you're good. Yeah, you're going to see what he did. Oh, you see, he want to diminish my role. Talk about that Ray.
Greatest defense in the history of college football.
But we still had to score some points on the offensive side, Skip.
7-3
Shannon, I really liked how you said it was last chance you for AB. I agree there. It's also a little bit last chance season for the Cowboys.
Oh, yeah. Right now.
They're sitting at 2-5. Orlando, please do stick around. We got to talk about your former team and their struggles next. No mercy, no mercy.